Many people credit Casey Becker with being the first victim to fall to Ghostface's killing spree in 1996. It wasn't actually Casey that was actually the first person to be killed, as we all are aware. Maureen Prescott's death has become such a talking point for Scream fans because it was a death scene that we never actually saw happen on screen. But the events of that murder caused such a huge effect on the Scream universe. It was what inspired and caused all the killings for 4 and now 5 movies. And while some of you are quite divided over whether you want to hear some more information about Maureen Prescott's murder in the new Scream movie, I decided that I'm going to do a video on Maureen Prescott's death and see if we can try and find out how she was actually killed. Hello everyone and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream. If you're interested in Scream content or you just like Ghostface in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell icon to stay notified for future content. Maureen Prescott's death inspired the entire events of the first Scream movie, and then the subsequent sequels afterwards pretty much followed because of the fact that Maureen was killed that 1 year prior to the events of Scream in 1996. So we know very little about the actual death, but we know quite a lot about Maureen's past. Maureen Prescott went to Hollywood and was named Rena Reynolds by herself as a stage name and tried to make it into Hollywood and tried to get into movies, and she came across Milton, the movie director, who she was trying to groom, if you will, to sort of get into big movies. And she starred in quite a few of his movies, mainly horror films, and then eventually, trying to win over some directors, she was brought into Milton's home, where she was raped by the directors and producers who she initially was grooming to become a movie star with. The ordeal traumatized Maureen, so she ended up leaving and going back to Woodsboro, and decided to forget all about the past until she found out she was pregnant with Roman. And Roman, because he was connected to the Rena Reynolds past and how horrific, you know, the events were of that time in her life, she sort of gave Roman up and shut him out of her life for good, and then met Neil Prescott, where she started a relationship with him and then eventually had Sydney. So what went wrong for Maureen Prescott? What was it around that time that changed everything? Well, because of the fact that she had a very tragic past, it's very easy to understand why she became so promiscuous, why she was with Neil Prescott. Because some people become so damaged by the past that they feel that the only outlet they've got is to sort of become the very thing that people were calling them. And because of the fact that people didn't really know Maureen Prescott's history, you know, even Gail Weathers didn't actually know about that part of her life. She just knew about her time in Woodsboro. Maureen Prescott ended up sleeping around with different men in town, so much so that the actual town itself actually started to name her a slut. They were all very aware of how promiscuous Maureen Prescott had become. Roman actually tracked who she was and turned up and wanted to sort of have a relationship with his mom, but she rejected him because, as I just said earlier, she was closing out that whole history of the fact that, you know, she was raped in Hollywood and wanted to forget about that time. And unfortunately, Roman took the brunt end of Maureen Prescott's rejection of that stage in her life, and because of that he became enraged and started stalking her. And the stalking of Maureen was the beginning of a very, very dark time in Woodsboro, and also the beginning of what we would say is the story that inspires the Scream movies. So she was stalked quite a long time by Roman, who had found out that she was sleeping with different men. You know, Cotton Weary was one of them, and Hank Loomis was one of them, who was the dad of Billy, and Billy was Sydney's boyfriend. Roman filmed them together, Hank and Maureen, and decided to use the footage to inform Billy of how Maureen Prescott was ruining his life. From this point on, the details are very slim. I'm presuming that maybe Billy did actually tell his mother about what had happened, or maybe she had the affair with Hank Loomis before Roman showed it to Billy, and then possibly maybe Billy was upset and distraught that his mum had left him, and then Roman showing him the video of who'd caused it was the cherry on top of the cake that made Billy go the way he was. I'm going to go with the latter, because I just think that for him to have been told this information, to tell his mum for his mum to leave, would have just been a stupid move on Billy's part if he wanted to keep his parents together. Then after that, because of the frustration that his mum had left, Billy decided to kill Maureen Prescott, and Roman instructed him to frame somebody if anything went wrong. And from this point on, this is where we got the story of Maureen's death. Now, nothing's really been detailed about Maureen Prescott's death. The details are very, very slim. So telling you guys about this death is going to be based on what we know and just based on my opinion. But the concept was to frame Cotton. I think that they must have waited for Cotton and Maureen Prescott to sleep together, possibly when Neil Prescott was away on business. And I think that Cotton would have gone in there, slept with Maureen, and then they instructed the whole thing to look like he had raped her. So I'm guessing what would have happened was, I'm not overly convinced they would have phoned her, just because I think that if Maureen Prescott was somehow alerted or alarmed by the fact that she was getting phone calls, I think that somehow Sydney would have been made aware of it. I think she would have gone and woke Sydney up, because Sydney was in the house at this time. And I don't believe for one second that they would have phoned her and she wouldn't have told Sydney. So that is being ruled out. I think that they just killed her. I think what would have happened was Cotton Weary would have left the house, and then I think that Billy and Stu would have been hidden somewhere, maybe so creepily stalking her. Maybe when she was having sex with Cotton, they were watching, or they were somewhere in the shadows waiting. And then the moment that he'd gone, they both came out, and I think that they killed her. And judging by the crime scene set in Stab 3, it's looking to me like it was very much a bloodbath, and I think that it would have been some sort of stabbing frenzy, and it definitely happened in Maureen's bedroom. So I think they maybe would have been hidden in the wardrobe somewhere, and they would have exposed themselves and killed her like that. The struggle was heard from Sydney next door, and I think that Sydney would have been a bit unsure to go and check. But one thing that's very unclear is, the girls in the bathroom in Scream 1996 were talking about the fact that Sydney watched her mum get butchered. I don't know how true that is. I don't know if Sydney actually saw her mum get butchered, or whether she just found her mum's body. Now, in the events of Scream 3, when she was going on the stab set and she walked into Maureen's bedroom and the set was set up for the murder scene, it was pretty dark and Sydney's reaction was very traumatic, and I expected it. You know, it's a mum, but it sort of gives me the feeling that maybe she did sort of see her mum get killed and witness some form of it, which, you know, if she did see her mum get killed, maybe they weren't in the ghost face costumes, because she said she saw Cotton wearing the jacket. And I'm gonna guess that because at that time when Scream came out, Cotton and Billy had very similar hairstyles, I'm presuming maybe she saw Billy from the back in Cotton's jacket. But the fact that she didn't see the costume sort of tells me that maybe they weren't actually wearing the costumes, and maybe they'd just gone to kill. Maybe the costumes came in when Casey died. So I'm guessing that they actually killed her in the bedroom, and Sydney must have witnessed it from, say, behind somewhere, or she may have gone into the hallway and had a look and seen it. Maybe she witnessed her mum get murdered and then sort of hid in the panic, and then maybe afterwards she saw the killer walk down the steps and leave the house. From behind, she looked down and it must have looked like Cotton. And then I'm guessing that Sydney found her mum's body and then informed the police. But because the DNA of the liaison that Maureen had with Cotton, it was very fitting that it looked like she'd been raped. The details on Maureen's death are very far and few, so we don't really know that much. I'm just sort of piecing together to give you guys some overall picture of what happened. I hope this kind of gives you guys sort of a clear picture as to how she may have been killed. You know, I don't believe they would have been in the Ghostface costume. I think that Billy may have been there as himself, and I think the Ghostface costume came in after. Maybe he got a love for killing. Maybe when he said to Sydney, it makes psychos more creative watching horror movies, maybe it's because after he'd done Maureen Prescott, he got a thirst for killing and decided to go back and watch all these horror films to get inspiration. You never know. But what do you guys think? I hope you've enjoyed this video. It's something that I've never done before. It's just giving you guys a brief view of how Maureen Prescott died, and it's something that I know that a lot of you have wanted, because you're all fans of details on Scream, and I am too. So here's your video on Maureen Prescott. Thank you very much for watching the video. Don't forget to like the video, because that always helps this channel out. Head over to the community section on this channel, where you can discuss Scream with fans from around the world. I'm posting polls and discussions daily. I think it's time we left this video on a quote from Scream, where Stu describes Maureen Prescott to Sydney.
Yeah, we put her out of her misery. Because let's face it, Sydney, your mother was no Sharon Stone.